see, you'll be talking. You hate it. Hate it. I said they hate it. God be doing and me having no sand. God, it's your girl Queen Lizzie. Hello, family Queen Lizzie. We are in the building once again. This is your girl Queen Lizzie. And today I'm not going to waste your time at all. Like, thank you all for the subscription. Hey, the English is there. It's bomb book. Don't mind me. Okay, so thanks to those who have already subscribed, and to those of you who have not yet subscribed, I say thank you. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit on the notification bell so that anytime I upload a new video, you'll be prompt to watch it. And the bell notification, if you're clicking on it, click on the all so that any video I upload, you'll see it. It will just prompt you for you to see it. You watch it, please. Okay, let's get into the video. Today I'm here to tell my Arab people, like my fellow kadames, my fellow shagales, yes, as they call us here. So today I'm going to tell you some little secrets you have to be doing so that they will like you. If your madam or your boss, yes, they will like you. Things you do and they like about, yes. One, you have to be clean. Make sure you are neat. No, you have to make sure you are neat. If you wake up in the morning, bath before you start your work. Yes, because they don't like to hear some scents, small scents in the armpit and those kind of things. They hate that. Even though they themselves, they don't like bathing, brushing their teeth, but they are the first person to notice someone smelling. They are the people who notice someone is smelling, but them, they don't like bathing, they don't like brushing their teeth. Even if they see you bathing every day, they want you to be neat, but if they see you bathing every day, they will even tell you you'll get sick. And how possible is this? How can I get sick by bathing? It's just funny, right? How can a person get sick by bathing? Like, by now, we are all dead. Yes. So one is be neat, be clean, just be clean for them. Even though we know how they are, but you have to be clean for them. Yes, and it's good for your own body too. So the second one is, don't be talking anyhow. Keep secrets. Whatever is going on in the house, make sure you don't, like, if you're having their conversations, you don't put your mouth inside. Like, if you are not invited, you are not invited, my dear. If they ask you something, you can respond, but if they are talking or they are sitting, they are guarded, talking their own, they are having their own conversations, and you just batch into them and you are also talking, they hate that. They hate it. Concentrate on your work. It's because of the work you came. So concentrate on your work. Simple. Happy you here. Okay, so let's get into number three, is waking up on time. If you get to the house, the first day you get to the house, those set times, they will tell you what you have to do, and the time you have to wake up and the time you have to sleep. So just follow their rules. Simple. Wake up. If they say 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock, wake up, do your work. If they say sleep at night, now you are going to your room. Even though sometimes in the time for sleeping, they'll set for you, but sometimes they have parties and those kind of things, and you have to stay till they finish the parties. You wash the dishes before you go and sleep. So that one, I think, for that one, it's just consideration. We consider them, it's our work, we can't say no. And sometimes too, you finish your work early, maybe they will set time for you to sleep like 9, and by 8 you are done, you can go to your room. Simple. You don't have any problem with them. So the number four is waking up on time. You have to make sure you wake up on time, and they are going to love you. And number five is, not listening about. They hate it at all. Because of money they are paying you, they don't want you to be lazy. Like, they don't want a lazy person. Yes, lazy person, that's a word. I'll not put myself in trouble by speaking any English. I don't even understand. Yeah, so they hate laziness. Laziness, they hate it. So you have to make sure, because you are working for the money, be strong. The work is not easy. Be strong. Don't be lazy. Work hard. Yes, what you know, if you wake up, you go straight to your work. Work. You know from morning, I'm going to clean, I'm going to cook, I'm going to do this. You know all your work. So just arrange them one after the other. So if you wake up, there will be no stress for you. You know what to do from here to here to from here to here. Simple as that. If you're not lazy, they like you. If you are not lazy, even if you're not, if they see that you're not lazy and your time is up, your 2 years contract is up, and you're going to you want to travel back to your country, they always plead with you to stay. And some of them, those that if your time is due and they are rushing to even let you go, that means they don't even like you at all. But if they really like you, If they really like you, if you are going, they don't want you to go. They want you to stay. So, my fellow kadamas, my fellow shagales, let's keep fingers crossed. Our work is not easy though, but that is what is fetching us some money. In there, I need some money. You understand? So at least we can solve family problems. We can solve our own problems. We can save money for our future. Yes. So please, guys, be strong. Be strong. Be strong. Be strong. I love you all. Thank you. It's your girl, Queen Lizzie. Subscribe to my channel. And I'll be giving you more of this. Because from now going, I'll be concentrating on the Saudi lifestyle. Yes. To those of you who have subscribed, to subscribe to my channel, please. I'll be concentrating on the Shagala lifestyle in Saudi Arabia. I'm in Saudi Arabia, so I'll be giving you all the details and what's happening, our lifestyles in Saudi Arabia to you. Thank you guys, I love you all.